I'm Mike, and this is CAS Tech Tips. On our ACS V5 system here, every process is governed by a series of sensor inputs. To demonstrate these, we use what's called the path of the can, which is where we take a can and move it through the system to identify at each step what it's looking for to move on to the next. Coming into your infeed, the first sensor you're going to see is called the can count sensor. It's mounted to the rails here right before the fill head. You want to make sure this is in the correct position by placing a can right in front of it, and you should see an orange light come on. If you then take that same can and pull it against the opposite rail as far as it goes, if that orange light starts to flicker or turns off, there's too big of a gap in the rails and you need to make an adjustment. It's also important to note that you don't want the face of the sensor contacting the body of the can, as that can cause the sensor to fail and seaming issues later on. The machine's going to count six cans as they move under the fill head, and then we're looking for two more things in order to start the process. The first of these is the gate cylinder needs to be closed. There's a sensor on the gate cylinder here which should light up orange when the gate's in the closed position. The last thing we're looking for is the sensor mounted higher up on the fill head cylinder here. That one should be lit up orange too. If all three of those conditions have been satisfied, the fill head's going to drop. At that point, you're going to see the uppermost sensor on the fill head cylinder turn off and the lower one turn on, at which time the fill is going to start. To continue on with the path of the can, stay tuned to our next video. We'll see you there.